Good evening, everyone. Joe for JaspysHobbyland.com here on April 15th, 2017. Right there. This is break number 42 because it's Jackie Robinson Day. And I'm wearing my Kansas City Monarchs hat. Jackie Robinson Day, this is break 42. 11 box moonshot baseball mixer. Thanks to Casey for grabbing the Red Sox. I said Nick Tater. You got to pay attention, Nick. And there's everyone else right there. So for break 42, good luck everyone. 11 boxes right here, right? 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, there you go. All right, and here it is. We're gonna start with Prism Baseball first from 2015. Go back in time a little bit. You're looking for two autographs per box on average. I think I know what I said. No, you don't worry about it. All right, I'll open both of these boxes at once. Doesn't really matter. Your name's on here. It'll go to the right place. As long as your name is correct on here, I could call you Terminator. The entire time. I can call you Bob the entire time. But as long as your name is on that piece of paper, that's the key part. The exciting thing, obviously, is going to be that autographed baseball. Who knows what could pop out of there? The TriStar Odyssey could have a little some surprises back there, too. This as well. So there's some pretty fun stuff. Some pretty good stuff, fun stuff in this Moonshot Baseball Mixer. On the 15th, Saturday. So thanks for spending your Easter Saturday with us, folks. Really appreciate it. I know a lot of people have stuff with a family going on or family in town or whatever the case may be. So I appreciate everyone hanging out with us. Moonshot Baseball Mixer on Jackie Robinson Day. People often ask me, Joe, what's the best card you've ever pulled? Probably a one-of-one cut auto of Jackie Robinson out of, I think, National Treasures Collegiate Baseball, I think, something like that. So he was in his UCLA gear, you know? All right. Matt leads us off, and Alexi Ramirez, tie-dye for the White Sox. Out of one out of, exactly, Nick. That's exactly what's going to happen. And our first autograph is Gregory Polanco, gold. Nice, 7 out of 10. That's you, Nick Tater. Nice. I like Polanco too, that's strong. All right, so nice autograph to start things off. David Price on the back right there. There you go, Nick. See? Your patience has paid off. Dalton Pompey out of 99 for the Blue Jays. After this, Carter probably honors. That's like the next closest. Jake Arrieta. Maybe that's a variation. I'll leave that aside. Set that aside right here. RJ Alvarez is your other autograph. Goes to the Padres. Yeah, for the next break, after this break is over, so this mixer will take about half an hour. After this is done, I think on the website, Honors Football was down to six or seven. Down to four now, so probably Honors Football after this. Flawless Football is at 17. We could probably do that at some point tonight. Mason, I'm not sure off the top of my head, but But I will look that up once this break is over, unless all the teams are sold out by then. David Price, 53 out of 75. Flawless won't fill tonight, Carter. Not with that attitude. I hope everyone has the opposite attitude that Carter has. I say it will fill tonight. I don't know. It's a random break. It's a lot easier to fill. Die cut. Jock Peterson, camo refractor. 197 out of 199. I got to be here for another like 4 hours, Carter. It better fill tonight. That goes to the Dodgers, of course. That'll go to Chad with the Dodgers. Anthony Rizzo and David Robertson in the back here. There you go, Carter. Flawless will fill tonight. So get your flawless spots right now, folks. Only 17 left. Halfway there already. Pedro and Raimer Liriano for the Padres. 86 out of 99. That's going to go out to San Diego. That'll be for Donald. Chris Sale, White Sox edition. Camel refractor, 40 out of 199, that is. Mike Trout again. Fresh Faces die cut, Dilson Herrera and Justin Verlander. 49 out of 149. Greg Holland closing in Colorado now. Didi Gregorius should be off the DL soon. And Cespedes. This is Tigers. Can you imagine how... Can you believe how many times that guy's been traded around? He's crushing the ball right now, though. We got a orange Mike Moustakas. 1 out of 60. And our next auto is, nice, Aaron Judge autograph for the Bronx Bombers. Nice one, Yankees. I'll go to John Parker. Matt Harvey, Gary Brown, and nice. On Jackie Robinson Day, there's Yasiel Puig, 42 parallel, 33 out of 42. Nice one for the Dodgers. That'll go to Chad. Could be a comeback season for Yasiel this year. Be interesting to watch throughout the season. And that was your two boxes of 2015 Prism Baseball. Let me sleeve up these parallels really quick. And we'll do a couple boxes of Topps Chrome, and then we'll move into this stuff right here. So a lot of parallels out of this, which is nice. It's always nice. And four nice autographs out of here, too. Here are your autos. All right, well, yeah, Nick. Out of 10, Polanco, right on the card, too. That is pretty nice. So, congrats, man. Thanks for getting in. See, you can't get it if you don't play. You can't win if you don't play. So, I'm glad you played, Nick. Out of 10, too. That's a pretty low number. So that was 2016. Now we're moving into 2015 Prism. Now we're moving into Chrome 2016. Sub Evan, what's going on? Doing well. All right, so that's one box. Here's another box. Let's open all these guys up. That's right, the kick. Scared money don't make money. Don't be scared, folks. Honors is almost filled. Ladies and gentlemen, we just posted that earlier today. Honors football is filled. I think it's only, three or four teams away? And then once that's done, I mean, we'll have plenty of time to fill up another break, so let's try to rally around something else. I know the website at the moment is looking a little on the thin side, but there's still plenty of fun breaks to get into. Plenty of big hits to be pulled tonight. Nice, Eddie. Eddie Smith says, finally bought to my first break. Honors Giants. Excellent. Thank you, sir. Welcome. So what, two autographs per box, I think? So we're looking for four autographs in here plus parallels. When's the next Topps Chrome baseball coming out? June or something like that? July? Looking forward to it. It's always a pretty solid set every year. Yeah, Honors is going to be pretty great. Yeah, I'm surprised that you've done so well with the Panthers. You know, I mean, it's kind of it's priced low just because there aren't too many hits there. You know what I mean? So, So it's nice that you do hit. Nick Tater asking, have you, Joe, you ever pull an auto from these packs? I'll let you think about that one really quick. Yeah, these were in the last three mixers. And we did full case breaks of this too, so. 31/75, future stars Carlos Correa, wave. That goes to Jake and the Astros. Joey Rycard, prospect for the Orioles. That goes to Mark. Ciesla with that one. There you go, Mark. Slide that aside over here. There's a bunch of other different... Everything ships, so if you see me miss like a numbered card or something special or something like that, fear not, because they'll all come your way. And Jared Eichhoff for the Phillies. For the Fightin' Phils, going to James Davidson. I heard on the radio that the Phillies may be considering going in for Manny Machado and Bryce Harper, like at the end of 2019 when they're free agents. Like, because they believe, this is what I mean, this is the scoop that I've been hearing. I've been hearing that there are guys like Aaron Nola and Jared Eichhoff, Mikhail Franco, Tommy Joseph, guys like that will kind of be getting into, you know, have some seasons under their belt, and they'll be ready to add like a Bryce Harper or Machado to their team to really put them over the hump and get them into, you know, baseball success. And I guess they've got money to spend. They don't have any big contracts kind of holding them down at the moment, right? I think Ryan Howard's done with the Phillies. So, I mean, if you think about it, they could be, they, because everyone just assumes, oh, you know, only the Yankees are going to have money for those players. Only the Dodgers, only, you know, certain teams. But you forget about the Phillies. You know, they're quietly building, collecting prospects together, you know, and they could come out of the blue and make a big push for a big name free agent. So, all right. So Eric Coyle saying they have no money on the books after that year. That's crazy. So, I mean, that could definitely be, you know, Philadelphia is a great sports town too. So, yeah, they've got the money to spend. There's Mark Melancon, 38 out of 75 for the Pirates. That's for Nick Tater. And Joey Reichard for the Orioles. 2 out of 150. So blue Joey Reichard for the O's. Mark with that one. So that free agent window is gonna be very exciting. For this particular break, yes, we do ship everything that you see. It doesn't take that long. But that's why in some of the breaks, like if we did like a full case break of this Topps Chrome stuff, Nick, there's Colin Ray, we would say, oh, we're not going to ship out veteran base. Colin Ray, autograph for the Padres. That'll go to Donald Brazier. Yeah, that is true. The kick is saying, hey, well, it obviously depends on whether Bryce wants or Machado want to sign with the Phils. True. But they could definitely make the decision harder because they could spend money too. You know what I mean? So money talks. If Manny Machado believes that the Orioles are going to be unable to build a team around him and other young players, or if he perceives that a big contract could maybe even hamstring the Orioles from, you know, adding pieces to get them to the World. I don't know. You know, a lot of things can change, but it'll be interesting to see. It's Francisco Liriano. And, oh! Almost missed Alex Gordon blue. 37 out of 150. Going to the Royals. That parallel going to Karen Steele. All right. Check out Bowman Inception. Well, Eric, from what I understand, I think the suggestion was that Mikhail Franco would be pushed to first base. So you would put Machado, a better fielder, at third base, and Franco's not too bad himself, but you move Mikhail Franco out to first base. Tuki Toussaint for the Braves. I don't know what you do with Tommy Joseph. Maybe he's expendable at that point. Ryan Kay with the Braves. You've got Hunter Cole for the San Francisco Baseball Giants. That goes to Brent. I actually did not see the Cavs-Pacers game. What happened? Cabrian Hayes for the Pirates. And Nick Tater. For the Astros, Francis Martis, 81 out of 99. Stroh's auto going to Jake. Yeah, only if Joseph isn't there, right, Eric? Yeah, well, see, that's what I thought too, but a lot can change. I think Mikhail Franco has traditionally been ranked higher than Tommy Joseph, right? So I don't think they'll have a problem moving Tommy Joseph. 43 out of 99, Jersey Auto, Rafael Devers. Or maybe you put him in the outfield. I don't know. I don't know if he has that kind of flexibility, though. But hey, if you have the chance to sign Manny Machado, Eric Coyle, I'm assuming you're a Phillies guy, but Red Sox Auto, that goes to Casey Lawson. There you go, Casey. Last spot mojo. But if you have the opportunity to sign Manny Machado, I think you guys will make it work. You know? If Manny Machado continues being the player that he is, and if you have the chance to sign him, I think you'll make it work. Like I can't see the Phillies going, oh, but we do have Tommy Joseph locking it up at first base. Sorry, Manny Machado. We're not going to need your services. I appreciate your interest in coming to Philadelphia, but I mean, what are we going to do about Tommy Joseph? Robert Stevenson. Cespedes, who's been crushing. Johnny Bench. Michael Fulmer. And our autograph is Jose Canseco, Tampa Bay Rays edition. Oh, congrats, Casey. First hit for Jaspys. Good. Nice. So that goes to the Tampa Bay Rays, going out to Alex Lindsay. There you go, Alex. You're on the board. And I believe these are Asia exclusives. 51 out of 80, these gold ones. So that's Trevor Story for the Rockies, going to Ryan K. Carlos Correa and Nelson Cruz. Oh, you guys have a lot of outfield prospects? Right. Well, listen, like I said before though, hey, if Manny Machado can be had in Philadelphia, I'm sure the Phillies front office will figure out a way to make that work, make that move work. Bryce, where does Bryce Harper go? Everybody. That's another question, right? Where does Bryce go? A lot of people speculating Yankees. That seems to make sense. Does he really go there? I don't know. Vlad Guerrero. Nice Hank Aaron. 93 out of 99 for the Braves, going out to Ryan K. Is this the auto? Yeah. Braves auto. Andres Galarraga. Nice. It's another one for Ryan K and the Braves. I think the Dodgers maybe will start soon now. They're at home. Should be a 7-10 game on a Saturday. 15 out of 60, Stephen Piscotty for the Redbirds. Rick with that one. Here's a little something for you, Rick. Here's the other two, Nomar and Madison. All right. Let's see what we have in these nice things here. Let's do the Odyssey first. Right. Try to center that camera a little bit better. All right, here we go. Everyone can guess. Oh, it's a photo, I think. Okay. Is there a card here? There's usually TriStar is usually good about including a nice little informational card that I could read off, like I'm a game show host. I don't want to spoil that. Do it this way. Let's slide this out here. All right. I think some of you may have seen the card already. It's inside here. Well, it's Pete Rose. That wasn't going to be very hard because once I said that, everyone would get it. You realize how many hits he has? A lot. Look it up. It's amazing. Pete Rose, 8x10 autograph. Authentication sticker right here. Nice photo right there. There you go. Cincinnati Reds, Ryan K with that one. Oh, the Dodger game must start at 5 something then. No, 6:30 maybe, 6:30 start, 6:10 start. All right, so nice. Reds with that one. And the next one. You did your senior thesis on Pete Rose? Like about what? I'd like to hear that. Yeah, 4,230. Yeah, it's a lot of hits. I agree, Paul T. I'm of the mind that he should be in the Hall of Fame for those hits. Clearly not for anything else, but as a player. Okay. Here we go. Everybody can guess right here. I was born in 1907. In the year of our Lord, 1907, and I died in 1991. I'm a seven-time All-Star selection, and at his retirement, or at my retirement, I was the all-time leader for the most games played and for double plays by a major league shortstop. Hall of Fame in 1964. Hall of Fame in 1964. Anyone have a guess? And he played for this team his entire career. And he was a manager for the Kansas City Athletics for one season in 1967. His number four, he's number four, and his number four was retired by this team. Alexi Ramirez, nice. No. Number four retired by the Chicago White Sox. It's Luke Appling. I believe cut auto. Oh, no. It's one of these Hall of Fame autos right here. Nice. There you go. Luke Appling. Played for the White Sox his entire career. So no, like, weird, awkward randomizers or anything like that. There you go. And that is for... Ricky Jones with the White Sox. Nice. Actually, I can set this aside right here. All right. So that was good. Nice. Let's see what Leaf Best of Baseball has. One buyback card. And then they have the 1991 Leaf Acetate throwback card. Good luck, everybody. So the first card would be... Alex Rodriguez, right there for the Yankees. And PSA 8. PSA 8, 1978 Topps Baseball. We have nice Eddie Murray. That's a good grade, too. PSA 8, 1978, Eddie Murray. Look how young he looks there. Nice. So that would be for Mark and the Orioles. Nice. And the baseball. Again, for the baseball, we'll also use our usual... We usually use this rule for college players, but we'll also use it if there's not a team clearly associated with it on the baseball. Like, autographed baseballs, it'll always go to the team they played for the longest, if they're retired, or the team they are currently on. So I think all of these should... Oh, it's over here. I think all of these should make sense. Right? So, like, if it's Reggie Jackson... We'll look up what team he played for the longest. Yankees, I think. Was it A's? Same with Randy Johnson. I believe Randy Johnson played for the Mariners a couple seasons longer than he played for the Diamondbacks. And obviously, you know, Chris Bryant's still active on the Cubs, so that'll go there. A lot of these are pretty obvious. All right. So this is by TriStar, Hidden Treasures. It's pretty good. Let's see. They also, I love the informational cards they put here. Feels like a game show at this point. All right. I am an 8-time All-Star, a 1978 American League MVP, 6 times top 5 in MVP voting, a 3-time home run champ. Like, this guy never won the won the MVP once, but other times top 5. Hall of Fame 2009, 8-time All-Star. Who am I? And played 16 seasons with this one team. Not Reggie Jackson, not Clemente. Obviously, Clemente couldn't have won the AL MVP. Eddie Smith and Nathan, I believe, have it. Jim Rice is correct. Played all 16 seasons. Nick Case is Jim Rice as well. Played all 16 seasons with the Red Sox. There he is. Hall of Fame in 09. Does he have Hall of Fame numbers? I guess so. Lifetime 298. Won the MVP once. 382 home runs. 2,400 hits. Boston Red Sox, Casey Lawson with the last spot mojo. Here it is, Casey. An autographed baseball coming your way. There's the authentication stickers right there. It's 26 out of 36. And Jim Rice's autograph. Nice, nice placement on that too, Jim. So there you go, boys and girls. I think I got nothing to randomize. Perfect. What a clean break. A lot of fun too. Jim Rice, Casey, thanks for joining us, folks. Really appreciate everybody joining our break. This is our 11-box moonshot mixer number 42 in honor of Jackie Robinson, who used to play for the Kansas City Monarchs. Of course, a Dodger legend as well. I'm a big Dodger fan. Thanks very much, everybody. This is Joe. We'll break with you next time on JaspysHobbyland.com.